Okay, what's up, everybody? Let's check and make sure that y'all are on and get a little view of the room today. Yep, y'all are on. The black window, clock, and everything. And here we go. I actually did the vlog earlier and I hit the power button. So I'm sitting there talking to myself. But hey guys, what's going on? Anyway, we're going to take and do some, I guess you call it some more teardown videos and stuff, because really don't have nothing to do. It's raining. It's like 54 degrees out. Snow's all gone. That's a plus. Snowblower's back at the shop where it belongs, instead of the trunk of the car. Anyway, couple of things I want to hit on. I most likely will not be leaving YouTube. I will most likely go ahead and stay. The only thing that I do not really like about it is that I'm going to lose my ability to have thumbnails. I hate that. And I'm really hoping, I don't know if it's involved in it or not. I'm really hoping that I can still create 15 minutes plus videos. Because if not, YouTube is going to put me down as a spammer, because when I do 30 minute long videos like most of them have been lately, I've actually noticed people like longer videos. About 30 minutes usually people starting to like, so hey. Thumbs up if you like 30-minute videos. Let's see. I'm not going to beg. Some people on here, and somebody on my channel here that is subscribed to me is begging for subs. Not going to be the one to say it, but I'm going to say this. Begging for subs, to me, in my opinion, makes you look desperate. The thing I've read on this YouTube thing is, if you have 1,000 subs in 200 hours or some crazy number that most of us small YouTubers aren't going to have, most of us small YouTubers are not going to have. You have to have that 1,000 for a year, if I read it right. I'll probably get corrected in the comments, but if I read it right, you have to have that for a year. Okay, my suggestion is, if you want to get back at Google or YouTube, which, you know, you can bark all you want, they just throw you nothing and tell you to go home. I mean, they're a big, rich company. They don't care. They're in there watching a movie. I don't know what to watch in there. It sounds weird. Anyway, as I was saying, if you want to get up back at him, you want to stick it to the man, down here in the description, right down there at the bottom, is a link. Adblocker Plus. Now, I'm going to tell you this. If you download it, I use it all the time, but if you want to support us smaller channels for till the 20th, which I don't think the ones that's not getting paid, the ones that are getting paid ain't got the problem. It's the ones that never really did get paid that has the problem. We're not going to see none of it anyway. But if you want to download that thing, put it on your computer. A lot of people's like, oh, well, we could get YouTube Red and not have ads. Thing is, with YouTube Red, is the people that are on there are making money off that. The people on there get the revenue. You don't watch videos, but they still get the money as if you did. Adblocker, if I understood it right, is it takes away the ads and it kills the revenue that was generated from them ads to that person. And that right there would actually, if enough people did it, would try to maybe make them go, hey, You know, our revenue's really dropped lately. Maybe we should rethink this. A good company would do that. Well, a good company would leave shit alone, quit frickin' screwing with stuff, but... yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna get done with that rant. We're gonna take and look at some stuff. I've got a radio here in the floor. I'm thinking about doing... just take it apart and see what's wrong with it. I've also got the big stereo back here. I thought about getting into it, but nah. That thing would take days to get into. Maybe next video. Really ain't got much left to tear into. Apart from the... yeah. Ain't got much to tear into. Maybe we'll take this little boombox apart. No, you know what? I got a stereo down here in the floor y'all need to look into. I gotta touch up some stuff in it. Because it is crazy. It's weird what's in them. You'll be amazed of how much space the friggin' thing takes up and what little's in it. So, here we go. Give them big stereo here down here on the floor. Maybe my place marker. Okay, here we go. This is actually really going to shock you guys about what's in this thing. It's got dust and dirt still in it. Yeah, it's not screwed together no more because I've had to take it apart so many times. Fix what I'm going to do, and of course I am in the squeaky chair. But there it is. Go ahead and take y'all off this and let you guys see it. Okay, let me make sure I'm gonna hold my thing over it. Okay, this is just your, I ain't got it. It takes a power cord. But you see how big this thing is? I mean, here is a C battery. C battery. That's how big it is. There's the lamp that I'm using. Okay. This has got the aux input. It's got AM and FM and the 3 CD changer. Okay, you think. This thing's probably huge inside, right? They got all kinds of electronic garbage in it, right? Well, I think we've got some screws in it here somewhere. No, I ain't got no screws in it anywhere. Let's pop you up on the tripod. Move you guys over here. You guys can kind of see it on my shoulder. Okay, let's put you guys up here. And let you guys see kind of over my shoulder of what's inside. This top comes off. And there's a couple of ribbon cable. There's a ribbon cable in there. And there's a ribbon cable that goes here. We unplug it. There's a little connector in here. This one can come unplugged as well. And then that takes, this is just, what I've unplugged is just the CD changer. As you can see, there's the motor for the turntable. The actual CD changer unit, or the CD reading unit. Yeah, what do you see inside there? What do you see? Nothing. I'll stick y'all off here. Stick y'all off a different way. Kind of get a... sorry about that. What do you see in there? That's right. Everything that's happening in this thing is on this board right here. All the programming and everything is on this chip. Come on, focus. There you go, it'll focus now. I figured out how to make this camera actually focus. Well, it ain't gonna focus that close, but we can move it in too. But yeah, that little chip right there has everything on it that you need to do. This ribbon cable. Yeah, these two cables are just for the CD thing. I could actually just pull them out because the CD thing doesn't work anyway. The display would still work. Now this is the amplifying board. You know, I've got your capacitors here, a couple of little ones down here. This is your amplifier, a little heat sink for this chip. I don't know. Must be some type of a switching amplifying chip or something. There is one screw in it. It's actually what's underneath it's the problem that I'm having with it. But yeah, you could actually, if you wanted to, you could take and shrink this package down to a little wooden box, because here's your front display, and this one actually has, I ain't gonna be able to see in there, as you can see, well, you may not be able to see now because of the white balance is all out of whack, but yeah, you might be able to just barely see it. Yeah, right there. As you can see, the tuning is not part. Put the knob back on. As you can see, the tuning is actually really smooth, really loose. The tuner and the volume is not attached. It's attached to the actual motherboard here, which is screwed in. There's a screw right there in the middle. And I just took a picture. Why, I don't know. But there is... Come on. It ain't gonna focus. Yeah, right there. See the screw? Right here. That's the only thing that holds it in. I'm thinking a person could, and there's nothing wrong with doing it. This is the ferrite rod. Ferrite rod right here for your AM. This is your FM antenna. A person could probably take that out and mount it in a little wooden box. Or a nice little wooden cabinet. Like, if you could find something that looked like that. But, you know, not that, because that works. If you could find something, yeah, you know, like, make a, like, let's say make a cedar box and put this board in. Because this board is everything. And you could actually, since these are two-prong, these little plugs have got prong here, for your left and right, or your left and right speaker. You could actually take the speakers, hook them into this, and you could, you can put that in a box. But yeah, that's kind of crazy that that's what's in some of these cheaper stereos, is they're just, they're empty boxes. And I know that the tape player would have been here. And if you look down in here, I think that's where the, I think, as weird as it looks like the power cord would come in right there. Because there's where you would make your little loop, and then the transformer would sit here. But, I don't know. I think it's kind of odd that it's made like this. there's nothing over here. And I just find it a little odd that they could have condensed this thing. Well, the CD player mechanism, you know, a little bit different. But as far as this goes, this could have been condensed. I don't know. All I know is that if I could find like a cedar box, yes, I most definitely would put this into a cedar box, because this cable right here, this is the only thing you could fold this up, since it is a ribbon cable. You know, you can literally fold these things up and everything. I would do away with the CD player, because the CD player don't work. So I would actually pull this cable and this out and just have this. Because this is where you're amping your power. So your power goes in here on this one. Yeah, see, your power goes in there. And it is a 12 volt DC. No, it's 13.5, but 12, it doesn't care. And then your antenna, you know, it's just a little strip wire antenna. This is made by RCA. I'm just found that out. Didn't know that. But yeah, this is made by RCA. RCA China. So, yeah. When you're eating Chinese food, think of an RCA radio now, I guess. No, I can't get it to focus on that. But yeah, I'm trying to get the date code. Oh, it's down there. There you go. It's not going to let me. Well, there you go. November 2014 was when it was made. And as you can see, RCA, yeah. Anyway, I just thought I'd show you guys this real quick. Now that I'm sitting here thinking of this, I think it'd be pretty cool to put that in a box. Like a cedar or mahogany, you know. Some type of wood that's got real good color and characteristics, like the old radios like that over there does. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool, I think. Well, anyway, guys, take a look outside. Show y'all what it looks like now that the snow's gone and the rain's coming down. That's what it looks like now. That's what it looks like now with the rain down, coming down a little bit. I gotta go get the UPS uninterruptible power supply. I gotta go get it because my mom's gonna drop it off. She had it. She said she didn't want it. It don't work. So I'm gonna get it, bring it home, and next video will be on that. So look forward to that. So, as you guys stare out into my window, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And thanks for watching. And have a good day.